Hello everyone, I am Shauni Devriza, doctoral researcher at Skin Research Group, and today I'll be discussing some key insights from our latest article, namely geographical differences in dupilumab treatment outcomes for atopic dermatitis. So, dupilumab is a monoclonal antibody which targets IL-4 and IL-13 pathway and has shown strong efficacy in clinical trials for atopic dermatitis. However, these standardized trials don't always reflect the complexity of real-world clinical care. So to investigate whether regional factors, such as clinical practice, influence dupilumab's efficacy and the presence of adverse events, we performed a systematic review. Systematic searches were conducted in several databases with keywords including atopic dermatitis, atopic eczema, combined with dupilumab. Studies including adult patients with atopic dermatitis treated with dupilumab and reporting percentage EASI reduction at weeks 12 or week 16 were included. Additionally, these studies should have originated from a single country or similar region. Letters, case series, case controls and post-hocs were excluded, as well as concomitant systemic therapy or other skin conditions. Out of nearly 11,000 articles, 28 articles met the inclusion criteria and were categorized by geographic region. We identified 7 articles from Northern Central Europe, 11 from Southern Europe, and 9 from East Asia. To quantify whether there is a geographic difference in the percentage EASI reduction, a meta-regression adjusted for geographic region, baseline EASI score, and the proportion of female participants was carried out. Interestingly, East Asians and Northern Central Europeans had significantly lower EASI reductions compared to Southern Europeans. Moreover, Northern Central Europe had the highest incidence of reported adverse events, in which profiles of adverse events varied between Europe and East Asia. In conclusion, our review highlights that treatment outcomes with dupilumab are not uniform across the globe. Regional factors, be they environmental exposures, reimbursement policies, or population-specific immune profiles, may be driving factors. Therefore, continued research is needed to clarify these influences so that we can further optimize the care for patients with atopic dermatitis. Thank you for your attention.